About Duminda Silva, actually Duminda Silva, you know, he, even though he did terrible things, he still, you know, helped the poor people a lot. There's no one, you know, after Sajith Premadasa and Mr. Ranasinghe Premadasa, who helped the poor, you know, urban slum people. First of all, of course, it's President Ranasinghe Premadasa, then followed by, you know, we can see Sajith Premadasa, and then we can see Duminda Silva, and also Jayanth Silva, former UMP Borel organizer. Those people help the poor a lot, especially the urban poor, the slum, the lower, the poorest of the poor in the urban, you know, areas. So I think in this context, Duminda Silva must be given opportunity to continue that service, because he is really good in doing that. He has some, you know, ability to do that in a good way, you know, and he must be corrected and directed to do those work. And perhaps, I think, he can be like a, you know, person, you know, even like a minister in charge of the urban poor, rehabilitation of the urban poor people's livelihoods. Because we can see in Sri Lanka, there are a lot of urban poorest of the poor in the urban areas, like Paliyagoda, you know, adjoining the old Kalani Bridge. We can see the underneath there are a lot of shanties, and also there are still, there are so many places. There are in Colombo, several places, there are a few places, not like earlier, that, you know, Sri Chanar Sarangara Mavata, you know, Colombo, Kohuala to Pamankara Road Junction. Just before the Pamankara Junction, near the church, the road behind the church, in between the, you know, the canal, the dirty canal, dirt, it full with, you know, filled with dirt, and just the canal, and next time you get a church, and in between there's a road heading towards Hampden Lane, you know, the Valavatta Hampden Lane. In that lane, you know, those areas, there are so many, you know, urban slum people living in those areas in a pathetic condition. So, and also I think in areas like Vanathamulla, you know, it's a terrible location in Vanathamulla slum dwellers, and also the Grand Pass, we know from the whole Grand Pass area, especially the Sri Lankan Muslim community, Sri Lankan Tamil community, and the Sri Lankan Sinhala community slums are there. Still, it's there. So it's a very pathetic situation in the Grand Pass, Mattakkuliya, those areas. And other than that, all other slums, President, you know, Gotabaya Rajapaksha cleared upon my advice when he was the minister, secretary to the urban, planning. So, but now I think Duminda Silva can be like a, you know, minister to look after those urban, you know, slum dwellers and improve their lives, education, you know, socially, you know, civilized life and family way-wise, and you know, technology, IT, education to their children, the stable income with some deposit in the bank, so some vehicles, some business to pursue. So this way, I think Duminda Silva can, you know, do a lot of work still, and he must be used. And also, I think Duminda Silva must, also get settled down in life, you know, not like being this, because otherwise he can ruin his life once again, you know, because he, I think, wants to help the poor people, and then he tried to find money from somewhere by doing something and get that and help the poor, you know, that's not the way. So I think in that case, Duminda Silva must, you know, get settled down in life, you know, married to somebody, and, you know, and then make a child or two or three, and then continue like this. I think when it comes to other things, he has a potential to reach the top in political career, provided he proves it. You know, it's up to him to prove, to go forward, and he has to prove himself, and then, you know, if he can, he has the potential, the full talent and the potential to reach the top job in Sri Lanka one day. That he has, if he can prove it, that he is loyal to our country, because he had done a lot of bad things to destroy the lives of people here. So if he can prove it otherwise, I think he has the full talent, you know, and the potential also. The full talents he has, similar to Mr. Arin Fernando, you know, who challenged President Mahinda Rajapaksha just before the, you know, presidential election in 2015, December or November, through Uwa Provincial Council election. He also had the same talents, but he ruined his life later, you know, due to various immoral activities at Shangri-La Hotel. And, well, that's what happens, right, unless you really commit to the country and do your work, you know, this is the outcome. So I think Duminda Silva must be given opportunity to, you know, do his work to this urban slum population. And I think Polonnaruwa area don't have much poor people these days, other than the Vallampitiya areas, so, and the, all the, you know, highly Muslim, Sri Lankan Muslim populated Colombo 11, 12, 13, 14 areas, which I think those areas must be, you know, extended as the new financial, extended financial district of Colombo 1. So based on such a plan, I think Duminda Silva can, you know, help to relocate those people and develop their lives, especially the urban poor. You know, there's nobody to support them now since President Ranasinghe Premadasa is no more, and his son Sajith Premadasa is more concerned about the national politics. So Mr. Jayanta Silva also no longer doing those work. I think it's the only person there is Mr. Duminda Silva. So he must do those work and give an opportunity.